Well, hey out there, friends, fans, feds, and frenemies. It's me, Postmodern Cowboy, and I'm back with episode number, I think this is 12, actually, of Going Medieval. Going Medieval is a community management survival game from Foxy Voxel. It's a lot like RimWorld or Dwarf Fortress, if you've played those. I really enjoy it. And we're playing in the Aberwyvern seed. Now, the Aberwyvern seed is so named for the fictional community of Aberwyvern in David Macaulay's 1980s children's architecture book called Castle, and an associated 1983 PBS TV show, a single episode, like TV, made for TV movie of the same name. It's animated. It's pretty cool. Check it out if you like. Architecture, if you like history, if you like castle stuff, castle is the gold standard. So I'm still fixing my mistake. If you watch the last two episodes, you'll know that I realized a little too late that the top of the map is only one level higher. So these crenellations that my folks are building there right now are actually the highest up you can go on the map. Which means that everything else on the map needs to be below that point. And, you know, it goes down a long way. that's what I mean. We could probably dig down from here multiple levels further, like probably three levels below that low point. So it's not the end of the world. It just means I need to dig down. And that's going to require a lot of mining. It's pretty much going to be a year or two in game of just re-leveling terrain. That's okay. I caught the problem in a way and in a time when it could be fixed and addressed, and didn't impact me too severely. And in fact, you know, actually, I thought these gates were going to be, this gatehouse was going to be short, but in the end, it's going to be very tall, and will look good. The you know, whole thing will look good. It's really what matters, right? Okay, speed time up here. Okay, you probably think I'm making a weird decision there too, but this will make more sense when you see what I'm doing. Might as well just relocate that down to the kitchen area down there. Now that that's built. So I can. Interesting. But that would... Oh, I established that that would get in the way of... Okay, I understand why I'm not doing that. In the end, I think that's okay. Keep an eye on my food stocks. Right. Right, of course. Is that, yeah, that's the block floor. At this point, this is all just cosmetic building here. The real defensive point is the gatehouse right now, and I'm definitely going to expand out from beyond. I'm going to expand out beyond the inner curtain here. Probably from the back two towers out, something on an angle. We're going to try to move some arable land. That's certainly a big priority, as any growing space, terrain to grow. Okay, now we've got stuff coming up, so put Osgar onto harvesting. Take him off of growing. We'll keep Peter on growing. Just weird that he's on growing to begin with, but I'm actually weirdly okay with that. Okay, are these harvestable? No, not even close. Okay, I'll let them finish this round tower before I have them shift over to mining again. For now, build it out like that. And again, this is all subject to change. So the next step is all right, again, I can't, boy, that's super frustrating. All right. And thank you. the library roof there. Why is that a wooden floor, I wonder? I'm gonna have to move the animal pen too eventually. Okay, is this, yeah, it's just finished. Good. Excellent, in fact. Okay, once the cabbages come up, we need to... Oh boy, they're not hauling as quickly as I'd like. Okay, Catherine can prioritize cooking. Mark can prioritize... how's the tailoring going? Everyone's got summer clothes now. So Mark can switch over to animal husbandry first, tailoring second. Cooking second, tailoring third. And Peter's replanting, which is fine. I'd rather him haul, to be honest. Osgar would also rather he haul and then harvest. Let's get all that brought in. They're not picking up the... Is my kitchen full or something? Is that what's going on here? No, not quite. Very nearly, though. Might need to expand. I'm gonna be honest, there isn't much space for food storage. Do I have wood? Must have a little wood, right? No, I don't. Okay, that's a problem too. So if I place these shelves, I have no wood to build them with. So I can turn these into bedrooms. Kind of seems like a poor use of the space, though. These are much better suited to armories. Yeah, I will move all those there, but it's not the biggest priority right now. Good, okay, we got some wine. Okay, let's get Andrew back in construction. Okay, good. And we have a shit ton of hay. We have a shit ton of barley. Starting to get them assigned back to their normal tasks. Oh, I blocked that in. Wow. Okay, that won't work. Okay, I'm gonna need to expand my food storage, but that's gonna go in the room with all the beds. Need to find a space to put in bedrooms. Oh, here we go. The cabbage in the basement rot? No. Couldn't possibly have. Must be somewhere else food is going. It's hard to count. Two, three, and it's there. Yeah, all right, that makes sense. Building a building in reverse is kind of weird. This is going to be pretty easy to fuck up. Cause like a collapse of the floor above. One of the things I need to do here is build a temporary, well, not temporary, but build a mining shelter so that, I'll build it. Maybe I do build it up there. Build it there. And I'll build it there. Now, it's not perfect, but sort of the school of fuck it good enough. Yeah, I need to put intermediate pillars. It's not perfect. Okay, so why am I doing this? Well, in the winter, when the snow falls, I'm going to want to mine some of this iron, and if the snow is sitting on top of it, I will not be able to. So, by roofing it, I become able to mine it properly. Just need a wicker floor there. Yeah, I just have not mined out underneath that one pillar. I managed to get this field replanted somewhat. What day is it? Summer day 8. It's too late now. I don't know who's in charge of the damn planting. Set as many of them to mine as I possibly can. Just keep working away on that. Kind of go all over the place, and they mine roughly wherever they feel like. Like, there's not... It's not like they start in one area, and just... They were over here, and then they were in here, and then they were over here, and then they were over here, and it's... Yeah, every time they run back to play board games or pray or do whatever they want. Or drink in church. Oh, Kevin's armor finally broke. I guess that means he'll go get more, because there's no shortage of that either. Yeah, I think these rooms here. Like that's large enough for. My bed takes up a lot of space, eh? It's large enough for a bed, which actually should be a wool bed, shouldn't it? Because that's the resource I have. Put a couple iron chests and a weapon rack by the door. Candelabra doesn't fit at the foot of the bed. But the room does need heat. Put a brazier beside the bed. I really need to put a standing armor rack, so maybe let's cut it down to one chest for their clothes. Standing armor rack. I don't even need a bookshelf, I guess. There's like art and tapestries and stuff I can put on the walls too. Yeah, I guess that's all a room needs to contain. There's no rule that says it's got to contain more than that. That's pretty good. I might as well put an iron torch on the door outside, probably on this part of it. Are they getting the mining done? Yeah, they're getting the mining done. Let's pull Andrew's the proficient builder. Oh. Okay, as far as weapons go, knightly swords, long swords, great swords, and war bow, long bow, and the crossbows. Perfect. It's considered to be a modest chamber. All right. Well. I guess it is, by standards. Doesn't mean I can get rid of one of these beds down here. Yep, this is working out pretty good. Oh, I see what my problem is here. There's no access to the roof of this. Two, three. Let's demolish those. Why did she only delete the one? She was wearing winter clothes. I guess she joined wearing winter clothes and never bothered to change it. I don't know why that doesn't reach. Why is Miss unhappy? Yeah, good shit. We're getting through that. Might be able to make that tower one unit bigger. And start to work on the aesthetic qualities here, right? Like, okay, yep. Still got lots of food. Oh yeah, okay, this will work out. will work out quite well, I think. Okay, we're getting on a fall now. That's good. Soon we're going to be in winter, and we'll have all that time for research and construction. I need to do all the excavation. We're going to mine in the winter too over here, but now that project's almost done. Perfect. Okay, now I need to start moving this thing. Just long. Oh, it is long enough for a neato. That'll look real good. Yeah, that's the final design we're going to go with. We're now the most influential settlement, dominating the entire region. Pilgrims travel far and wide to witness her splendor. It reminds me, I gotta get a map table down and see where the other factions are. I don't think we've had any visits from, like, Kingdom of York or any of the mainstream factions. The, like, I wonder if on this seed it's only the barbarian factions, you know, because we're the quote-unquote monarchist faction. I wonder. Guess we are knee deep in sheep now. This goat situation's getting out of hand. Oh boy. That's certainly not ideal. I wonder why. Makes a real damn racket, eh? Okay. I do sort of wish, and I have certainly said this in other videos, but I sort of wish that enemy attackers would use, you know, non-linear means. They wouldn't just try to fight their way through the, you know, stacked gates or doors, but they'd, you know, use a ladder to get over my walls. It would make the terrain more significant, and building different tiered defenses. You know, for example, crenellating the inside of the wall and using that to defend the inner courtyard when they get in. So they got to work their way up in a spiral and all the way around. Like, it would certainly make it more interesting. And I understand that there's some part of the developer roadmap which reflects a desire by Foxy Voxel to do that. I think they plan to like add siege wall-mounted siege engines and different types of siege engines and equipment. Okay, I might as well have them all knock off mining for the moment. Shift over to like Mega Hall and bring in all these seeds. I guess they'll need to round up. Oh boy, I really fucked that up, didn't I? It's just, what is it, copy? Is that the button that I want? Yeah. So by all rights, that should fit there, and I don't understand why it doesn't. There's no reason. There's no reason. Yeah, just like that.
Commander, where furniture? Is it not stable? Again, there's absolutely no reason. Except maybe... No, that doesn't make sense. No. Should work. For some reason, it doesn't. Am I out of bricks? I'm out of bricks. Well, that won't do at all. Who are my brick crafters? Okay. So we currently have a hole in the wall, but that's okay. I'll patch that really quick. I'm not out of bricks. Okay, so the hole in the wall is patched now. That's good. Things are just gonna keep on going. Perfect symmetry. I think that's where I'm gonna end this one for today. I'll pick back up another time. I don't know about these windows. I really don't know about these windows. They look kind of ugly, but I might expand these rooms just one little bit more. see if I'm able to. But yeah, that's all for me for now. This is Postmodern Cowboy playing Going Medieval, a community management survival game from Foxy Voxel. If you like watching me play these games, let me know what you think down in the comments. If you do not like watching me play these games, or if you think I've made some more critical mistakes, let me know down in the comments. Throw me a like, subscribe to my channel, tell your friends, and as always, keep it peaceful out there.